Welcome to our channel Electrical and Control Engineering. We provide the research simulations in the field of optimization, specially power systems and renewable energy resources.
Thank you very much. In our previous video, we have simulated a 3-bus system that in the first transmission line was 115% was overloaded. There were one generator and two loads, and this first load was 115% overloaded. So they are two loaded. The power flowing through this line is 114 megawatt. 15% extra load flowing power flowing through this one. So there are two ways to overcome this one. First, to install a generator at bus 2 or 3, and second by installing a second one. So this, in the first way, we have installed a generator at bus 2. So here we can set the megawatt output of the volt of that generator. So let's 10 megawatt and 30 megawatt its output. So we have selected this DG at bus number 2. This is not available for AGC, this is not available for AVR, automatic voltage regulation. So later we will see how, what's the effect on the AVR if we select the AVR capability of this generator. So this is 30 megawatt, 10 megawatt generator that will reduce the overloading of the first transmission line connected at bus number 2. So you can see here, sorry, again we have 10 megawatt, you have to click on it. It has to be 30 megawatt and 10 megawatt. Okay, so if you take in server this DG, click on it, so you can see that the first transmission line is reduced to 82%. So now the first, you can see that previously here 114 megawatt was there. This second transmission line also not overloaded. So the current flowing through this, the power flowing through this transmission line is reduced, and 30 megawatt is provided by this DG to the load. So keep in mind this is not selected for AVR, so that has a maximum megawatt capacity of 150 megawatt. So let's see what's the effect of if it's available for AVR. Click on available for AVR. So here the voltage he will try, this generator will try, is 1.01 per unit at this bus. So this DG will try to adjust the reactive power in such a way that to maintain the 1.01. So you can see the first transmission line is overloaded to 158%. The reason is that it started backflowing the reactive power to this line through this generator, because this generator could not maintain the 1.01 voltage. Instead, the voltage at this bus is 0.9. So 150 megawatt is generated by this generator. This generator tries to generate maximum available reactive power, that's 150 megawatt, to this back, to this line. And the voltage maintained by this 0.99. So this generator was unable to maintain this, tried a lot, it's trying to maintain. So again we have unselected, but first we have to reset and then we have to reduce the limits as the limits There is 150. This is selected by the AVR. So double click on it. And in the megawatt control output, so reduce it here at 10 megawatt and then click OK and then run it. So it will be in the previous state. So the voltage at this one is now 0.98. So you have to flat start whenever you made any change. So if you reset it to flat start, then the result will be correct. So that was all about the placing generator at bus 2. So let's remove this generator and connecting our transmission line in parallel with the first transmission line. So let's placing this transmission line in parallel with the first. This has same characteristics as the already installed. So remove this generator. Okay, remove it. We have opened the breaker and removed this generator. So we have installed an parallel transmission line. So you can see. So run it. So previous case 115%. So this overloading of the first transmission line is reduced. You can see that previously the current flow or flowing this was more than 400. So in this case the current flowing through this transmission line is 481 ampere. So also the voltage and the downward direction in the downward bus is also reduced.